I would like to talk to you about the number five. And the thing that I like most about the number five is that there are only five Platonic solids.
This is a regular polygon, it's a regular triangle, and it has the same number of triangles meeting at each corner.
The definition of a Platonic solid is a shape where you've got sort of different sides to the shape, but all of the sides are the same shape. That shape is a regular kind of polygon, so like a square where all the sides are the same length and the angles are all the same, and every corner looks the same. So those are the conditions.
And this is in fact called a tetrahedron. It's like a pyramid, but it's got a triangular base, not a square base.
So a tetrahedron is four triangles.
This is the octahedron. It has eight triangular faces.
So if I get two of those and stick them together, you'll see that I also get the same corner everywhere else. And this is an octahedron.
So unlike our tetrahedron, this has four triangles meeting at each corner.
And this is one of my favourite Platonic solids. This is called an icosahedron. You can see every single corner has got five triangles meeting at it, and all of the faces are triangles. And in fact, you get 20 triangles. So this is an icosahedron.
This one over here, my marvellous pops. Well, Brady, what's that?
That is a cube.
Yeah, it's a hexahedron. Well done. So a hexahedron has six square faces.
So I'm happy with that, and I'll put a cube on my list. And that is six squares. At this point, I would jump to pentagons. I don't have any pentagons, unfortunately, but you can fit three pentagons around a point.
This is the dodecahedron. Dodec means 12. It has 12 pentagon faces. And at each vertex, we have three pentagons. Okay, so we're going to show that there are only five possible regular solids. So let's imagine we're looking at a shape that has triangular faces. Okay, so it has to have at least three. Let's think of a corner. There we go. Let's try to get that right. So there we have. Let's imagine this corner here. And around this corner are three regular triangles. Now, we've got this gap here. Here's a big gap, a space. If you glue this side to this side, it's going to be a concave shape, and that will actually be three triangles around a point. That will be your tetrahedron. Let's add another triangle. Let's make it like this. So now we've got four triangles. We've got this gap again. Now, if we glue these sides together, this gap, four triangles around a point, well, that will be your octahedron. That will make an octahedron, fine. Let's draw another triangle in here. So now we've got five triangles around a point. Glue it together. Here's a little missing gap here. Glue it together. And this will make your icosahedron, five triangles around a point. If you try to keep going, if you try six triangles around a point though, all you get is a flat object. It's just a flat piece of paper. It's not concave, it's not a shape. So that's as far as you can go. Seven, eight, you can't add any more triangles. All right, let's do the squares. Let's have three squares around a point. There we go. These are all 90 degrees, 90 degrees. There's a missing gap here. Glue it together. This side glued to this side, and you'll get your cube. If you try and add a fourth square to it, you'll get 360 degrees. You'll get a flat shape again. No point. Let's try the pentagons. That's all we have to do. Pentagons, I will do my best.
Pentagons are hard to draw, aren't they?
I'm a mathematician rather than an artist, so I may just leave it there. I think I'm going to struggle around this. But if I draw pentagons, a pentagon has an angle of 108 degrees. You can fit three around a point. If you fit three around a point, that would add up to 324 degrees, and you would have a little gap, and you can glue it together, and if you do it, you'll end up with three pentagons around a point. That's a dodecahedron. You can't fit four around a point. The angles are too big. So let's move on. Let's try the hexagons. Hexagons have an angle of 120 degrees. If you try three hexagons around a point, that will add up to 360.
You can draw them.
Okay, I'll draw those, he says. Let's draw three hexagons around a point. Each one has 120 degrees, 120 degrees, 120 degrees. It adds up to 360, it's flat. It makes a flat shape, it's not a concave shape, it's not a solid. After that, if you're looking at seven-sided shapes, eight-sided shapes, the angles are too big and they don't make regular solids at all.
Katie, I think the viewers are gonna have two questions. Here's the first question. Where does a sphere fit into all of this?
A sphere isn't a Platonic solid because it doesn't technically have faces. I guess in some sense the sphere is kind of the limit of having more and more faces. Like if you get enough faces, eventually the faces are all of size zero. But it's not counted as a solid of any shape because it's not got kind of individual faces that are a shape.
Okay. And the other question they're going to have is, where can I get some of those cool magnet toys?
These are amazing. It's called Polydron. They do like a clippy together version, but this is a magnetic version, which is like the Ferrari of Polydron. And while we're using brand names, I think this is really nice. They do sell pentagons, and if anyone wants to get me a very nice present, some pentagons would be much appreciated. But as it stands, I own squares and triangles.
Why?